This video is created upon request from SpotaGenius. The request is to create a Twitter tweet monitoring tool that continuously monitors tweets from a particular Twitter handler and filters the tweets based on some keywords and generate a desktop notification when the conditions are right. One of the things that you'll notice when you start looking for Twitter monitoring tools is that a lot of the tools, including the most popular ones, are heavily relying on the API keys offered by Twitter before you can start using the tools. So one of the drawbacks of going through this approach is, one, it's very difficult to get access to API keys. So that you have to go through a long documentation process and you have to wait for approval from the Twitter team before you can start using the APIs. So it's a long process. But there is an alternate, easier way to do it, and we'll talk about that approach in this video. So we're going to use a technique known as web scraping. And just to briefly explain what the process is, if you go to any website, so the technique that I'm about to discuss is applicable for any website, not just Twitter. So if you go to, let's just take Twitter in this case, because we want to monitor the tweets, right? So if you go to the website, we can directly read the tweets from that particular Twitter handler, right? So what we'll do is we'll call this API every few seconds, like every 5 seconds, and we deconstruct the data on this page to the essential elements that we need. For example, on this page, we are only concerned about all the tweets that are posted by the particular user, right? So what we're going to do is we're going to download this website every few seconds, then extract the tweets from that website, and then apply the filter criteria on those tweets. And when the conditions are right, we're going to generate a desktop alert. Okay, that's the process. Now I'm going to talk about how to use the tool. So first thing before you start running the tool is that you have to have Node.js installed on your machine. Okay, so if you look at my other videos, I've talked about Node.js. It's a very straightforward installation. I'll leave a link for this as well in the description box. You can download the current version and just click next and install it. Okay, and then you're going to go to this link, GitHub link. I'm going to share this GitHub link as well in the description box, and you can click here and download the zip file. And once you extract the zip file, this is what you would see in the folder. You might not see Git attributes and license, but you'll see all the other folders. Okay, and we have to run this run.js file to start the monitoring tool. Okay, so go to command prompt and go to that folder and click on node and enter node run.js. So this starts the bot. Okay, and in order to stop, right now the bot is running, and to stop the bot you have to hit control C. Okay, now let's look at how to configure the bot. If you open run.js in the file, you see a variable called thhandlers. So this is Twitter handlers, and here is where we specify all the handlers that we want to watch. Okay, so right now this is a JSON object. So if you don't know what a JSON is, JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, and it's just a name value pair. Okay, and it's quite simple. You just have to create all your handlers in the same format. Okay, so it has three variables: name, URL, and the keywords. So right now it's configured for whale watch. So the name, you can put any name you want. It's whale watch, so I kept it as whale watch. And second, you specify the URL. Okay, so if I go to whale watch handler and just control A and control C and just paste it here. Okay, and then here I enter the keywords that I want to filter the tweets on. So I can put long, BTC, ETH, etc. Okay, and the keywords that I want to filter on should be comma separated. Okay, so every tweet that we receive will be checked against each of the keywords separated by comma. Okay, so in this case it will be checked against long, BTC, and ETH. Okay, so let me create a new entry for my account, and I'm going to do a tweet, and we'll see a notification live so that you know how the tool works. Okay, so I'll just copy this, and it should be comma separated, so I'll just put comma, new line, and paste it here. Okay, and name, I'll just put my name, Karthik, and I'll keep my Twitter handler here, copy this and paste the URL here, and then I'm going to put some keywords. Okay, I'll put ash as my keyword. Okay, and I'm going to save it. So whenever I make a tweet that contains a keyword ash, it's going to return it's going to give me a desktop notification. Okay, this is not a good example. Generally, you might want to look for keywords like, you know, if, let's say if Binance is listing a new coin, right? So you might want to look for new coin listings or, you know, something that is valuable. Okay, but this is just a demonstration purpose. And one other thing is you have to use, if you want to get all the tweets, which is again, I think it's, if you want all the tweets, you can just subscribe to that Twitter page, right? This is only useful if you want to filter tweets. But if you wish to get all the notifications, like all the tweets from a particular handler, just use star as the keyword. Okay. So if you use star, you'll get all tweets. If not, just put a comma separated list of all the keywords. Okay. So right now I'm just using one keyword, ash. Let's see if this works or not. Okay. I saved it. Now if I go back to the page, I click node.run.js. Yeah. Right now it's running. Now if I go to my page, now if I go to my Twitter handler and make a tweet that contains ash, it's going to show a desktop notification. So let's see if it works or not. So I'm going to say I like ash color. Okay. Let's tweet and see if it works or not. Clicked on tweet. You see this? I got a notification. So that's how it works. I can make another tweet. Let me delete this tweet. I can make another tweet. This time it won't have hash in it. Okay, Vibgyor. I'll say I like Vibgyor. So Vibgyor, if you remember your childhood days, it's a rainbow colors. I like Vibgyor and rainbow. So this tweet does not have ash in it, right? So now if I tweet it, I should not get any notification, right? Tweet. Yeah, I don't get any notifications because it doesn't contain the keyword, right? But if I delete this and I make another tweet with ash, I wish Vibgyor had ash in it. Okay. And if I tweet, I should get a notification now. Wait for it. There you go. So it works. Okay. It's as simple as that. There you go. That's a quick demonstration of how to use the tool and how to customize it. And you can, the good thing about this is that you can add any number of Twitter handlers that you want, and you're not restricted by a certain number of alerts. So you can have infinite alerts. Okay. That's the beauty of it. And even if someone blocks you, you can still use it because we are not logging in to access the information, right? We are just directly opening that particular Twitter handler page and downloading all the tweets. So even if someone blocks you, you can still use this approach to monitor the tweets and, you know, do any sort of analysis that you want. Okay. Lastly, I want to talk about a couple of packages that I used to build the tool. One of the important package is Cheerio. I don't know how to pronounce it. Cheerio, whatever. So this package is essential to parse the data that we download from the site into HTML and then search for different elements like a header tag or div tag or this is HTML data, right? We have to find a way to, you know, parse it into HTML and search for div elements or, you know, so to deconstruct the data element wise. So this Cheerio module allows you to do that, and it's quite fast. Okay. The other package that I used, which is important for this tool, was Node Notifier. So this is the package that I used to generate desktop notifications, which you just saw on the right hand side of the screen, the bottom right side of the screen. So these are the two essential components that were needed to build the tool. And I'm going to share the code as well, so you can debug it and see how it works. And yeah, you can, it's quite simple. It's just less than 100 lines of code. And you can just debug it and figure out how it's done. It's quite simple. Okay. I hope you found this useful. Just leave your thoughts and suggestions in the comment section, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Bye.